Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Alpha Central, I'm your host Jack, and today we found the best moments when modern women get shocked by men's honesty. Now let's jump right in, right after you subscribe, of course.
Disclaimer, this video was made for strictly comedic slash artistic purposes. No offense is intended towards any individual featured in this video.
Okay, so what do y'all do for a living?
We're models!
Models? Oh, so what do y'all do as models?
We shoot everything, anything anyone wants us to. Yeah.
Even...
Sometimes.
How much does that pay?
About, like, I would say 100K a year.
Y'all make 100K a year?
Just starting out, yes.
And how long y'all been doing this gig?
About a year. One year, yeah.
So y'all made up to 100K?
Yeah.
Each, about. Not in total?
Yeah.
Are y'all capping?
No, we're seriously not. We had a photo shoot today, and we came to Nashville tonight, so.
Can I see the photo?
Yeah.
Let me see it. Hey, can we show the camera?
Yeah, we can.
See? I'm a model.
Okay.
Here
and what's yours? Holy sh**.
Wait, that's me, my so fat.
That's not you. That's me.
She's trying to claim
this
it.
Is
her. Oh, no. Y'all do
I'll
all,
show you more.
If y'all do all that in the nudes, would y'all do all that?
No.
Margo. Holy s***. Hey, my guys, come here. Well, hey, what do y'all rate these models right here?
She a 7.
Oh, man.
I like her.
A 7?
Yeah. If you got bigger, I'd give you like a 10. I ain't gonna lie to you. Hey, it was nice to meet you, bro.
You too, bro.
Yeah.
When your career is based on your looks alone, it doesn't last more than a year either.
A photo from a recently opened women's only nightclub opened up and take a... Look, buddy, not one bottle in sight. Just a bunch of girls sitting around on their phone, all looking at each other to pay for everything. Because you know who pays for the bottles? Us. Doesn't make any sense, man. No respect out here. They don't appreciate what we do.
So independent until it comes to buying drinks and actually doing anything at the club.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how smart are you?
Probably about 8.
What's the square root of 81?
Square root of 81?
I said it already.
That's not. Is it 9?
Yeah. On a scale of 1 to 10, how smart are you?
Like a 8.5.
Oh, yeah. This is going to be a good one.
What's the square root of 81?
Oh, 6. 7.
Square root of 81 is what?
Is it 7?
Nope.
I was going to say... Wait. 16, but...
16, okay. You're running a race. You passed the person in fourth. What place are you in?
Third.
Nope.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how smart are you?
Maybe like a 8, I think.
You're running a race. You passed the person in third. What place are you in?
Second, of course.
You're in second?
Second, yeah.
You sure?
Sure, I think.
What's 3 cubed?
Not sure, I'm not even gonna lie.
Okay. You wanna guess?
1?
No.
I don't even know.
One says 8, one said 8.5. All they had to do was say 9.
If you woke up as a female, what's the first thing you're doing?
Oh, the first thing I'd do? Start
start
complaining, yeah.
To who?
To anybody who's standing there. Anybody who's standing there.
Man spent his whole life taking it, and he can't wait for the day he gets to have the privilege of just saying things with no consequence. It's what I'd do, too.
It's the back knee for me.
It's the All-American Eagle wardrobe for me.
It's the almost in the car crash 3 times for me.
It's
the crying uncle for me. It's the constantly getting stomach aches for me. It's the only eating plants for me. It's the Disney obsession at 18 years old for me. It's the ensemble sophomore year for me. Oh, and it's the dropping out of a D1 school to go to community college for me. So.
It's the fact he saw the opportunity and took it for me.
No money. None of the females want to be bothered with you. Nobody want to bother with you. Nobody want to come around. But look, come here. Come here closer. When you, I see when you got a little bread. Look, you got a little bread. Look. Look, at least y'all abducted if y'all want to come around now, see? See? Look. That's what I go to tell you. When you got money, people come around. When you don't got no more money, everybody leave away from you. When you got this real bread, when you got bread, people love you. Look at this. Look at the ducks. You see how they are? Look, like they hungry for the money, but when I come back and try to get some, nobody won't give me none. Remember that in life.
Talk about leading with examples.
You are popping.
Don't touch my face.
Oh, I'm sorry. You look good, girl.
Stop ripping on me. Thank you.
She need to what?
Just need to pull that up.
What you pointing to? Why you say she need to pull that up?
Nothing. She already got a boyfriend, but no more mans need to see that.
This just proves that even kids know the difference between what you should and shouldn't be doing. That's before modernity beats it out of them. It's just like looking at the past and the future in the same frame.
What's your go-to search on the hub?
Oh, I don't do that. Nah, I don't do that.
No?
Huh?
Never once, ever before?
Nah, self-control. I don't do that stuff. So, nah.
Zero videos watched from
Cal.
Never?
Never.
Really?
Never. Yeah, never.
Damn!
That's awesome. I can't say this.
That's fine.
Funny how they tried to make him look like the odd one out, but this was just a man who recognized a time to change or just didn't want to disrespect himself on camera for views. What a time to be, or even her pet dog, as much as she'd be willing to take up arms and fight for the guy who's just a friend.
Did you know that in emergencies, the reason why we evacuate women and children first is so that we can stay behind and figure out the solution in silence?
Notice how she took a whole second to process what he said before laughing? This woman knew it wasn't a one-liner. It was just the cold, hard truth.
Okay, so me and my friend, a platonic homeboy, we went somewhere last night and we had to get out the car like 3 times. Okay, and he didn't open my door not a single time. So I let it go by a couple times and then I said, now that's your 3rd time not opening my door. And he was like, well, I feel like that's romantic. And I said, wait, this is a common courtesy, okay? I know we just boys, okay? I know we just boys, but I am still, okay? Treat me like a lady. Disregard the mustache and the whiskers down here, okay? I am very much still a feminine woman. Open my door. Open my door. Am I tripping? Bro, open my door, bro. What y'all think?
You might be a lot of things, but with that attitude and those manners, you definitely don't seem like a feminine lady.
I'm fat because I drink too much red wine and I don't exercise enough.
That's not true. You're not fat because of what you eat and how much exercise you do. That is the line that everybody is led to believe.
I left you now and ran up and down Leicester Square for 3 hours and then went home and had a piece of lettuce and then came in and did the same tomorrow and the day after that and the day after that. I would start to look like a supermodel.
Only for a few months and then you would stop. In fact, you would start regaining weight within the first year. That is a fact. That's not fiction. That is absolute fact. And there is literally no evidence that weight loss is going to benefit anybody's health, whether they're a child or an adult. I'm willing to stake my medical career on the fact that you are, that the lies that we've been sold about obesity, especially childhood obesity, are not true. They are there to benefit the weight loss industry, not to benefit children. Evidence is very clear. Up to 98% of people that attempt weight loss will have regained all the weight within 5 years. That is up to 98% of people, and that is absolutely unquestionable. Second thing, this idea that energy in and energy out and energy calorie deficits.
You're smoking. Stop.
Willing to wager that medical degree because it's already been used as a napkin and lost its value.
Did you marry me for my looks or for my brains?
You're really good at the giving brains.
Andrew, that is not what I was talking.
Don't know about her, but I know for a fact that she married him for his brutal honesty and wit.
No matter what you do, your woman is mad at you. If you work all the time, why you work all the time? You ain't never home. You always leaving me. I hate this shit. If you home all the time, why you all up under me? Let me get some room to breathe. Damn, stop sweating me. I hate this shit. If you make more money than her, you. I want to make decisions too. You ain't my daddy. I don't need you to take care of me. I hate this shit. If she makes more money than you, you broke motherfucker. You never have no fucking money. That shit. I want to make all these decisions. I need to be taken care of. I hate this shit. I can't take it. And the number one reason your woman's always mad, fellas, because you ain't her first choice.
It's a lose-lose situation where the only real thing you can do is, well, stand back and let her finish that tantrum.
Hey, here's a problem. This meme is pretty big right now. Let's analyze it. Saying goodbye to my type means giving up on either one of these good boxes and settling this icky yellow-brown color because she wants to get married, the top level of relationship, which she cannot do with her type. Because they keep putting her here or lower, which would be here or lower on the male side. So she can't get the guys that she wants and has to adjust her expectations, and you don't want to be the guy that got settled for. This guy was settled for by her. He proposed twice, and she said no twice, but still wanted to be with him because he was just a placeholder for the guy from her past that she wanted to come back. But hey, it's just one video, right? And it only got 237,000 likes. That's not that much of the planet. That's like a quarter of New Hampshire. Oh, but wait a minute. Saying goodbye to my type. There you go, 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 there you go. Some of them are normal and some of them are more, Jesus Christ. And they're doing pretty well. I promise I clicked on this one at random. That's half of New Hampshire. And that's what the TikTok girls are up to right now. So, is social media damaging relationship formation by giving people unrealistic expectations? Yes. I'm gonna go with yes.
Women like to complain that men don't know what they're talking about, and this guy right here brought facts, figures, and even made it colorful for that extra pop.
I like to meet a says, you know what?
Yes.
I'm a prostitute. I walk the blade. I sell my body. And this is what it is. You said something earlier that disgusted me, to be honest with you. You said this is just what I had to do. You live in America. People were to get here. In South Africa, it's the country with the highest unemployment on the planet Earth. I talked to a woman who's my mother's age who tried to solicit me for prostitution. And I respected the fact that she wanted to work for her money and earn her money. So I said, hey, I'm a podcaster. Let me interview you. I want to hear your story. Because people hear your story claiming that you had to do this. I talked to a woman who actually has to do this in a country with the highest unemployment in the world. You're deluded. And you know what she said in her interview? She said, if I could go to America and wash dishes, I would go there and do that happily and send money back to my family. Difference between you and women there who are doing the same job of prostitution? They do prostitution in some cases because they need jobs. You do prostitution because you need God. You're lost.
We've lost a lot of our morals because we wanted to chase this faux empowerment, and this man laid it to them straight.
Marry a girl with a BBL. No? Why?
You gotta get a big ass. You probably have some type of insecurity within yourself that probably leak into other areas of your life, and it'll probably make our relationship very difficult, so.
Would you rather date a fitness girl then?
I like fit girls.
The shock at realizing that some men out there, most men, aren't chasing women for what they had to pay to get done. Ladies who say they do these things for themselves are just lying.
Girls that are married that still go get their body done. Mm-hmm. Like, yo, you beat the game. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I'm doing it for me. All right. I know a girl that went to DR, got her body.
She died?
She almost died. She got two daughters. She had to stay in the DR for like 38 days, 40 days, because she couldn't get on a plane. Because when you're in high altitude, yeah, it opens up the stitches and you bleed and all that. She got two daughters. So what was more important, you getting your body done for some or you being a quality mother for your kids?
You're right. I'm going to cancel my appointment right now.
And y'all are blaming men on that. Yo, it's y'all fault that we going under the knife. It's not a fault.
Because women feel like they're losing.
Let this serve as a reminder that nothing, nothing is more important than your health and safety. Don't listen to the faux empowerment quotes online. Listen to what really happens when you lose your way.
Imagine if women couldn't wear makeup. Tell me about it. Because if women really could not wear makeup and it was actually illegal to wear, these girls would be so down bad. It's not even funny. Men would actually understand that these girls are really not that cute as y'all think. And it's just the truth. Men in this society see a version of these girls that is covered with makeup, and it's not the real them. I'm just saying, like, You see an example right here. Girl on the left has makeup, and the girl on the right is the same exact girl, just without makeup. It's actually mind-blowing, bro. Like, makeup should be illegal. How do you not see that this is catfishing? This is 100% catfishing. And a lot of people that will disagree with me are probably going to be girls. But you see it in your eyes right here. It's catfishing. Like, makeup saves a lot of you girls fucking, I'm just saying.
So much for women saying they don't wear makeup to appeal to the male gaze. Come on, how about we say things for how they are instead of standing on a soapbox every chance we get?
The ideal age.
I would have to say the person that I would marry right now would probably have to be between 32 and 43.
Okay, what would you want his income to be?
I was just having this conversation with my friend. You have to manifest a husband, girl. You have to really think about the lifestyle that you want to live. The lifestyle that you want to live. When it comes down to vacations and how many kids you want to have. Just like the lifestyle that you want to have. Just like the lifestyle that you want to have. My husband needs to be making like $650,000.
Woo-wee. All right. 32, 43, exclude married. Any race, minimum height 5'8", exclude obesity, and 650,000. 0.032, full-fledged caddy.
Exactly, the lifestyle that you want to live, not the one that you'll sit around and wait for a man to provide, only to tell him now that you want a fancier one and move on.
I think naturally any sort of intimacy,
I mean, are we talking
one about? Person does either the either yeah, both of them do and then they end up together,
or one of them does
and then they're not friends anymore.
You're gonna be devil advocates.
I've never been friends with a girl I didn't want to. Lies, bro. Never had a girlfriend who I didn't fancy.
But that's you.
I've actually had girlfriends who I'm not attracted to, and they still get it.
So anyone with a front?
Yes. I hate men.
The man's ready to spill the truth because he's not afraid of it. The women over there would take it to their graves because that means coming clean about the scam they've been running for years.
Are trying to buy some new 30-inch bundles. It costs $500. Yeah. My father needs some new medication. It costs $1,600. The light in my studio went out. It cost me $400. And T-Dog wants me to invest in his new movie and he needs $5,000. Yeah. Are you still planning on me giving you this $500 by Friday?
No, this broke at $500.
So you're calling me a broke at that needs $500. I'm trying to understand this logic of yours.
I don't have it, or you said you was going
to
give it to me.
I said I was going to give it to you because you needed it to get your 30-inch bundles.
Right. But
I'm the broke don't got $500.
No, because don't you literally went to
your don't worry about it. Okay. So I'm the broke I'm investing my money in movies. Oh, I'm the broke I can pay for my own hair. I can grow it. Oh, I'm the broke I'm over here taking care of my father or my homie or my fucking $250,000 fucking deal. The fact that I'm investing my money in business and family, I'm the broke when you don't have $500 in your cash yet. Yeah, let's make it make sense. I'm broke, fucking girl math. 4 + 6 = 2. Girl math.
She wants him to pay for what she wants because she thinks it's better to get a man to do things for you than to get up and work for it yourself. Then she'll complain she's single.
I'm gonna give you the answer.
Okay.
You are older. Name me the product that gains value with age and use.
A product that gains value with age and use?
Yeah.
I wanna say...
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna say your mind, but I may be different. I may be.
No, I said a product. Where can you go buy a mind? A product.
Oh, a product. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure you're gonna tell me.
Yeah, nothing.
Oh, I am.
Nothing. And let's just talk about your cookies. They're getting older and they've been used.
That don't mean nothing.
You're right. They don't.
Oh, you are honry. You are
honry. No, I'm honest. I'm honest.
Man just kept coming back with one shot after another, and she just couldn't take his honesty.
28.
Are you single?
Yep.
Do you think dating has gotten easier for you now at 28 than it was when you were at 22?
Probably the same.
Why do you say that?
I just haven't noticed much of a difference.
But do you think 28-year-old men are going for women who are your age or younger?
Yes. I mean, a lot of 28-year-old men are still interested in me. I don't know what to tell you. I think you may have a point when it when it's a little bit older, but in like 28 age range, I don't think it has the effect that you're thinking it does.
And that's in your experience?
And that's also what the data bears out.
Okay, what does the data say?
When guys want kids, they're looking for younger women, but when they had kids or they didn't want kids, they just looked at how attractive the woman is. They didn't really care about age.
Do you want to have kids?
I don't know yet. I want to have kids in my mid-30s if I do, so I have time.
But don't you think you're like more fertile right now?
I mean, I'm pretty rich, so I could afford IVF and whatever I need to. And I don't mind adoption if I have to.
Sure. But even then, why even like spend money unnecessarily?
Because I'd rather have kids later when I'm ready. Also, the data also shows that people that are born or children that are born to older parents typically do better.
The data shows that women will make up just about anything to get out of confronting the truth.
His mom got mad at Marshawn Lynch for cussing at her kids during their football practice, but got checked immediately.
Yeah, I do. I cuss a lot.
That's okay.
No, my son's is not okay. So look, is there a man here with you? There's not a man here with you?
What does that matter? It's my son.
If they're not doing what they need to do, then yes, there's consequences. When I tell a kid to do something and they're not doing what they're supposed to do, then there is consequences. Like push-ups, like running laps,
like telling them to get sit-ups,
like telling them to get out of my drill if they're not participating.
Get out of my drill,
or whatever it takes to get my drill. Because there's one kid, but there's also 100 more kids out there. I understand that I'm not going to be able to please everybody, which I'm fine with that, but I appreciate it though, sweetheart.
He asked her if there was a man with her, not because of sexism, but because he knew that she was the one who thought he would have to pipe down when a woman was talking. Sorry, we left chivalry when y'all took up the faux equality.
I ain't no real I'm a father who's never been to jail on his kids.
You snitching on your own kids.
I will. You goddamn right I will.
Exactly.
You goddamn right I snitch on my own son, but I ain't gonna show my hole of my ass for my to get no money. And I hope my daughter don't either, because she graduated this year at 15 and her daddy bought her a car. She ain't got to go finish no man for it. Daddy been here since day one.
He's not a real man in her eyes because he's not ready to have kids disrespect him or themselves in the name of empowerment. That's what I call a real man, and that's what I hope to see more of in the world.
Let me see your natural hair. Let me see your natural hair. Let me see. Hey, she got fake shoes on.
Insulted when he wanted to see her natural hair? Yikes, imagine if he'd asked to see her natural face.
What happens is women become very delusional in modernity because they can't see all the hidden wires, right? So everything that you see is backed with hidden wires, asphalt, things like that. Everything that you see, the infrastructure that you walk on is basically taken for granted. And most women have no idea how any of that's even constructed. They just basically live within the paradigm that modernity kind of creates itself. That's why so many of them become delusional and say a world without men is easy, because they have no idea what they're talking about, essentially.
They're staring at him trying to form a comeback because no one likes being called out, or the truth for that matter.
What are your thoughts? I mean, you know, and I've said this before and I'm gonna get in trouble. I don't know what the difference between our Christian right and the Taliban is. I have no idea what the difference is.
Well, I'm pretty sure if you travel to Afghanistan, you will quickly find out what the difference is.
No.
A whole lot of nothing comes out of her mouth, and all that just to keep up a politically correct appearance.
You're not Indian culture, yeah?
At least we know who our dad is.
She doesn't like two things, being tolerant or hearing the truth about herself.
Bro, being a single mom is literally the hardest sh**, bro. Like, you cannot do anything. I literally got like one side of my weights wrecked at the gym because I tried to work out and they're calling me over the intercom to come get him literally after 5 minutes because he don't want to be with anybody but me because I'm the only person with him. But you literally just can't do anything. I'm literally so exhausted from work like 90% of the time, so I don't ever get to do like a good like real workout. And I got up trying to do a workout this evening and he don't even want to go to the kids club. This is like the third time I've tried to take him.
Myself wishes that he could be okay with the childcare so that I could get a workout in. My son is 17 months old and this has by far been the hardest stage of all of it. Hi, baby.
She's crying because she doesn't have enough me time for herself. Yeah, that's what happens when you decide that the best thing is to break up a family unit and chase a life that only looks good in Hollywood. You guys have made it to the end of the video. Make sure to like and subscribe to prove you're an alpha. And remember, according to YouTube, the best way to help the channel in the algorithm is to watch another one of my videos right after this video. So if you like this video, you should watch another one. Till next time.